To do research, the most important thing is curiosity. We had to ask the right questions and then try to solve it. How my research was started is, I think I had to trace back to my childhood. We keep tiny little fish in a jar, and I look at them, and I just feel like there's a lot of things that I can learn from them. And my curiosity, it led me to become a scientist. And here I am. I studying zebrafish and look at the developments of the zebrafish to help to treat human disease. During the Ebola crisis, the amount of people that they die from it is horrible. When we hear about their experimental drug, they use it to treat two American doctors in a very late stage of the infection, and they still be able to save their life.
I don't think that anybody was expecting a pandemic of Ebola to just crop up basically the next day. ZMAP was really being worked on by a biotech company, which could really essentially serve as a cure for Ebola. And all of a sudden, the Ebola outbreaks broke out, and they were trying to scale up that technology.
We heard that they are trying to produce it in a larger quantity, but they're still not able to catch up. These particular CMET antibody, they were produced in plant, in tobacco. They can produce a dozen of doses to treat human in a month. So the production is way limited. Every day in the lab, we grow microalgae and use it to feed vertebrae, a tiny vertebrate, and then use that vertebrae to feed a tiny little fish baby. And I would just wonder, tobacco is a plant. Algae is also plant. They reproduce very fast. They double almost every day. And can we use the same plant system to produce larger culture? Then it may catch up so that can help the demand for these therapeutics. So then I start talking to my colleague, Jade, because he's a plant engineer. Maybe we can come up with some idea that we can make this process faster. To make such a therapeutic antibody is new to us, so we don't really have the resources to invest in this project. And we know this, the Research Opportunity Initiative for North Carolina University to develop new technology that can be used potentially for the economy of North Carolina. And that can perfectly fit to help us to support our new teams and to make our technology possible.
I got an email from TinChung reaching out to me, and then we had a couple phone conversations, and he was telling me about the project and the lofty goals it had, and I thought it sounded like a really good idea. And from there, we started moving on to get it submitted. The process starts over at NC Central University in Jay's lab. Jay's lab works with setting up the initial reagents that we need to move the project forward. Let's go over to TinChung's group, who works with Jim over at the research campus at NCCU, and produce the proteins that we're interested in. And I work on extracting the proteins from those plant cells, and then moves over to NC State University with Penelope to produce large amounts of algae for the process. Within the last year, we've been able to demonstrate with a marker protein called GFP to open the cells, to purify the protein, and now we're poised with these positive results to now move forward into the real work of the project, which is working with the antibodies.
In our system, they can produce these foreign proteins, these green fluorescent proteins, and the process works smoothly. And the same platform, if it works for Ebola antibody, it will also work for other infectious disease. For example, West Nile virus, rabies, and Zika virus.
But how can we now harness this fast-growing, scalable kind of an expression system to really produce an efficacious therapeutic? That's really what the crux of the matter is. Because ultimately, the clinic and the patients are out there, and they require a therapeutic that can really address their needs. That's really why research is so critical to the biopharmaceutical industry as a whole. Is really something that the industry needs to be able to sort of meet the needs of tomorrow.
Since my childhood, I know one day I want to study something great that means something. We are really grateful that the ROI has this funding possibility. This investment on our team on this project, it will make a big impact in the future.
Thank you.